guys, I got some exciting news. My stuff from Total Boats finally showed up. Shipping took a while, but finally came in. So now we can start a Boston Whaler project. It's a 13.7 Super Sport. I believe it's a Super Sport, the way the inside interior is. And it's got some, a few things here and there that are damaged, like the rail. There's a couple of small holes, and you gotta repair those. And there's a couple like gouges on the hull, right where the water line is. So I got the material now, and now we can start repairing it and get it in the water for the 4th of July. That's the goal. So this year, what my goal is to tighten her all up, get her watertight. Good enough for now. I'll slap a little bit of paint here and there on it, so it hides the bodywork on it. Can't go out in the water looking like that. And over the winter, I plan on just redoing the whole entire boat, giving it a full new gel coat with paint, and redoing the interior, because the interior I don't care for, because it's that starboard upgrade kit that they sell for Whaler, and I don't like that. I like the traditional mahogany board. So I'll be doing that along with, a stereo system. And stay tuned. Alright, so right here, along the rail, we got some damage that goes along here. So we're going to be repairing that. Can't be going in the water. With this, the rubber rail seems to be beaten up, so that'll eventually get replaced. And also, right about here, it's got some damage. I can see some foam right there, so that's gonna have to get fiberglassed and filled in. And there's a few other oddball spots. I think right here has got some damage. Feels a little weak. And maybe down here, definitely right here, I can see the glass behind the gel coat. And there's a few other spots. Got a couple of pinholes in the floor that have to get fixed as well. And there's somebody tried repairing this in the past. Pretty crappy job. There's a hole right here, which hopefully there's no water in there. I'm gonna have to hook up a shop vac and try to suck some of the water out if there is any. Which probably is, because it's been raining. And yeah, that's about it. Transom's pretty solid. I don't see any damage. This gel coat and bonnet paint peeling off. The trees do make a mess. But other than that, this side seems pretty good. I got the original Boston Whaler bow light coming in. I ordered that. And got some little bit of cracking here. Doesn't seem too bad. Little dings right here, but that's not that bad. My main concern is the railing, because that's got some serious damage. But like I said, this rail did 2 feet left, and right about here. So I'm gonna concentrate on that. We'll start cutting. Well, first gotta remove the rubber rail. We'll start with that.
This is my first Boston Whaler restoration. So I'm learning pretty much as I go. But I do have lots of experience in fiberglass work and motor work, but I am a busy mechanic. This rubber is pretty on there, it's all super stiff and hard. I'll definitely have to use a heat gun.
You can see somebody's already been in here putting screws. At least they use stainless. The plastic piece right here that holds the rubber rail in. It's all pretty much all banged up. If anybody knows where they can, where I can get my hands on some of this, just the back piece for the rubber rail, that'd be great. I've been finding a lot of the whole entire kit for like $279, but I don't need the whole entire kit. I just need this black, this plastic piece. I can't find any soon, which I'll end up doing. I'll just flip the thing upside down so you can't see the cracked half. But over the winter, I'll just probably have to buy a new one if I can't find just the plastic half. But right about here is the original rivets, and you can see where it cracked. The story behind this, the guy had it on a dock. It was storming out, and it kept on getting banged up against the dock. And that's the story how this got broken, from what he told me. But we're going to fix it, because it looks like crap. Here we go. Time lapse. Just leave up to here, but I need to get this wire out for the bow light, so I'm gonna have to peel this back a little more, because I don't want to cut the wire right now, because I'm gonna eventually replace it with some marine grade legit stuff. I can see it's been kind of twisted already, and this is probably the original wire. Who knows? But this boat has seen better days. And we're gonna bring this baby back to life and put her back in the water where she belongs. So let me get to the light, disconnect that wire, and we'll get this railing off of here. This thing was a pain in the butt to get off. But we got it off, and I got mixed screws here. I got Phillips and flathead. Yay. You can tell these guys were grade A boat installers. They should have stuck to fixing bicycles, in my opinion. Boston Whaler light's gonna look really nice. It's the one with the two mounts right here. You'll see. I'll put it in the picture. Alright, so I assessed some of the stuff out here so we can get access to this damage part of the railing on the boat, and some of it will have to be reconstructed. So I pretty much just wanted to get in here and see what I was looking at. Overall damage is not that bad. Foam is pretty much still there. A couple of spots I'll have to fill in with some foam. Other than that, I don't know what's up with these big long gouges. Probably from the screws getting maybe ripped out or something. I don't know. But I'll have to assess that. And pretty much just taking all this garbage that they put in there from the past so I can fill it in the right way with fiberglass resin. And yeah, and start grinding. Here, so I'm trying to assess some of the damage. It's kind of like it's got dirt, a little bit of mold in there. Trying to see if there's any water inside of here before I start filling this in with the close shell foam. Oh, I'm getting my mask on. Because I don't want to be putting spraying fresh close shell foam inside here and there's stuff that's dirty and wet, and just trying to clean it up, get it all nice and dry so I can make a little form and spray the new foam in here, and reshape it and lay the glass. Determine if I should bring it all the way out here, but when I was cutting all this out, it looked like it was pretty nice and dry and clean in there, so I don't think water and dirt got inside there. But for now, I saw it pretty like green and a little damp over here, so I wanted to cut this all out. Add more work, but oh well. Alright, stay tuned. Alright, got it all clean. Gonna use the cardboard as a template. Box this all in, and we'll spray the spray foam aside. But, ready for foam.
Things are great.